Good afternoon all. My topic is forensic analysis of glass. In this, I am going to discuss about introduction, type of glass, forensic examination of glass evidence, non-optical and optical physical properties of glass, glass fracture, conclusion, etc. Next slide, ma'am. Introduction. Glass can be considered as hard material, but brittle in its formation. It is like a solid but not crystalline, but rather has an amorphous structure. The atoms of an amorphous solid have a random, disordered arrangement. Unlike the regular orderly arrangement that is characteristic of crystalline solid. Another characteristic property of glass is that its softness over a wide temperature range rather than melting sharply at a well-defined temperature. Glass has been shown to be a very useful evidence because it is often encountered in criminal investigation. Next slide, ma'am. Types of glass. First one is soda-lime glass. Soda-lime glass is commonly used in windows and bottles. It consists of 70% silicon dioxide, 15% of sodium oxide, 10% of calcium oxide, and 5% of other oxide. The theoretical density for soda lime is 2.44 gram per centimeter cube. Then tempered glass. This is a type of safety glass processed by controlled thermochemical treatments to increase its strength compared with the normal glass. Tempering puts the outer surface into compression and the inner surface into tension. The theoretical density for toughened glass is 2.44 gram per centimeter cube. Next slide, ma'am. Borosilicate glass. This is a type of glass with the main glass forming constitution of silica and boron. Pyrex is made to withstand high temperature. It is commonly used for cookingware, etc. The theoretical density for borosilicate glass is 2.15 gram per centimeter cube to 2.25 gram per centimeter cube. Then a leaded glass. This type of glass has a variety in which lead replaces the calcium content of a typical potash glass. Typical lead crystal has a density of around 3.1 gram per centimeter cube and high lead glass can be over 4.0 gram per centimeter cube. Then windshield glass. Automobile windshields are made from laminated glass. Today, windshields are made into two layers of glass with a high-strength vinyl plastic film such as polyvinyl butyl being sandwiched in between the layers. The three pieces are laminated together by applying heat and pressure in a special oven called an autoclave. This type of glass is ideal for automobile windshield because of its strength and shatter resistance. Next one, ma'am. Forensic examination of glass evidence. To pinpoint the source of the glass evidence, the forensic examiner needs the two usual samples, glass fragment collected from the crime scene and a glass fragment taken from some item belonging to the suspect. The examiner must then compare these samples by identifying their characteristics. For example, their color, fracture patterns, fractures, and striation from manufacturing, unevenness of thickness, surface wear, surface film, or dirt, and weathering patterns. In particular, the examiner tries to fit the piece of the puzzle together by matching the irregular edges of the broken glass samples and finding any corresponding irregularities between the two fragments. Finding a perfect match is tantamount to individualizing the glass to a single source with a complete certainty. Next slide, ma'am. Non-optical physical properties of glass. Many non-optical physical properties can be used to compare a questioned specimen of glass to a known sample. These non-optical physical properties include surface striations and markings, surface contaminants, thickness, hardness, etc. Clearly, frosted glass cannot be a match to a clear window glass. Similarly, a curved piece cannot come from the same source as a flat piece. And finally, laminated glass could not compare to wire reinforced glass. Thus, these sorts of comparison are most useful in proving that the two pieces cannot be associated. Then, optical physical properties of glass. Optical physical properties of glass include color and refractive index. First of all, color. Comparing the color of a suspect piece of glass with the color of a reference sample can distinguish whether the two samples share a common source. As a consequence, significant color difference between glass fragments can be used as a basis for exclusion of a suspect. Then, a refractive index. The bending of a light beam as it passes from one medium to the another is known as refraction. The refraction index is the ratio of the velocity of light in the air to the velocity of the light in the glass being measured. The refractive index is one of the most commonly measured physical properties in the forensic laboratory because it gives an indication of a composition and the thermal history of the glass. In this, oil immersion method is used to measure the refractive index of glass. Next slide, ma'am. Oil immersion method. When using the oil immersion method, a forensic examiner places the questioned glass fragment in specialized silicone oils. The refractive index of the oil is temperature dependent. As its temperature increases, its refractive index decreases. Silicone oils are chosen for this task because they are resistant to decomposition at high temperatures. An easy way to vary the refractive index of the immersion oil is to heat it. The suspected glass fragments and the immersion oils are placed on a microscopic slide, which is then inserted into a hot stage microscope. When the glass fragments are initially absorbed through the microscope, they will produce a bright halo around each fragment, known as Bakelite. At that point, the refractive indices of the oil and the glass fragment are the same. So the examiner is no longer able to see the glass fragment that are immersed in the oil. The examiner can compare suspect and known samples in this way to determine whether they have the same match point. The refractive index of the glass from graphs that report the refractive index of the oil as a function of a temperature. Next slide, ma'am. Glass fracture. Glass bends in response to any force that is exerted on any one of its surface. When the limit of elasticity is reached, the glass fractures. Frequently fractured window glass will reveal information that can be related to the force and direction of the impact. Such knowledge may be useful for reconstructing events at a crime scene investigation. Radial crack originates at point of impact and moves away from the point. Then, concentric crack, broken series of concentric circle around the impact point. Conchoidal crack. Conchoidal fractures are shaped like arches that are perpendicular to one side of the glass surface and curved nearly parallel to the opposite glass surface. It follows the 3R rule. 3R rule means radial crack create rib marks at right angles on the reverse side from where the force was applied. Next slide, ma'am. Forensic examination of glass fracture. If all the glass pieces are present, the first thing is to check for is the hole made by the load or projectile. If the bullet came at an acute angle from the left, glass fragment will be sprayed to the right and the existing hole will be irregular oval. If the bullet came from the acute angle from the right, glass fragments will be sprayed to the left and existing hole will be irregular oval. This test works best when the hole is made by high-speed projectile. If the hole is made by a low-speed projectile, this test is not meaningful, so we have to examine rib marks. When there are several bullet holes, analysis can determine the sequence of impact. The majority of fragments recovered from the suspect clothing or hair will likely be very small. In such cases, the forensic examiner turns to measurement of density and refractive index to characterize glass evidence. Next slide, ma'am. Conclusion. Glass analysis include determining the type of glass based on glass fragments, However, the entire fractured pan or window can be helpful when determining direction and sequence of force. In this, we used oil immersion method to examine glass fractures. Thank you.